Hopefully that can happen by the end of the day.
You say Israelis have been running for their lives from rockets fired from Gaza. So tell me then, until this current confrontation, how many Israelis have been killed by these rockets from Gaza this year?
Well, you know the numbers don't matter. The fact that Israel has shot down
hundreds of rockets fired from Gaza. Do you know the answer to this? How many Israelis had died this year?
No, I really know that it doesn't matter, ma'am.
No, because why does it not matter?
I can tell you that Israel shot down hundreds of them. Each one of those rockets could have killed five people.
No, but how many Israelis were actually killed by these rockets?
Do the math. Assume that every rocket can kill five people. And there have been more than 700 fired since last week.
That was not my question.
The fact that Israel's protecting its citizens a lot better than any other country is.
Okay.
Israel has no reason to apologize for that, the same way that England and every other country wouldn't apologize for protecting its citizens.
Well, you're either unwilling or are unable to give the answer to that question. So let me tell you, The Economist says
because it's irrelevant, ma'am. It's irrelevant because Israel's protecting its citizens. But we're
trying to bring this story to our audiences around the world. Since 2004, according to The Economist, 20 Israelis were killed by rockets that came from Gaza into Israel. And this year, not one Israeli was killed by these rockets until this current confrontation began. Do you accept those figures?
Michelle, I would like you to see what it's like to be stuck in a room where you can't leave with your children for hours on end, that at any given moment a siren will go off that can go through your roof. The fact that Israel has managed to stop that from happening using defensive measures has prevented war, has prevented a lot of people from being killed on both sides.
Or certainly you could argue, couldn't you, that Hamas was also stopping a worse happening all of this period, because although there were rockets being fired, they weren't the big rockets that have caused damage in recent days. They were mostly homemade contraptions.
Because Israel, at the beginning of right after they killed the Egyptian, right after they killed Jabari, the Hamas general, they went and they destroyed the long-range missiles that Hamas had. Otherwise, the damage would have been much more. Hamas was trying to kill civilians with every single rocket that they fired. And the fact that they didn't succeed, the fact that Hamas is a failure over the past week is a very good thing for both sides.
Not all of them were fired by Hamas, were they? I mean, you know that, and I know that. Hamas is not the only group that's operating in Gaza.
But Hamas is in charge of Gaza. Hamas overthrew the rightful Palestinian leadership there, and since then has made life a living hell for their people as well as ours.